Welcome to Indian Clinical Radiological Physics Academy, and Merry Christmas to all of you. And today's topic is RapidArc Planning in Eclipse TPS. This is a screen that we are seeing that, you know, new course, and that's going to be a test. So you need to choose the target volume, and priorly you have to give the prescription dose and number of fraction. And then you have to choose the machine. And then you have to go to the geometry, choose the static mode, and then choose the energy, and then choose the tolerance table. Then go to the beam eyes view and adjust that. You should make sure that it is not an integer, actually decimal. It should be a full number. So adjusting the isocenter. Then make that 180, and then make sure that it is evenly distributed in the target. And you could see the depth, and then go to the algorithms and choose that, and we have accuracy, and choose that to 0.2 as equal to the thickness of the slice. Then check once again the description, and then go to the arc geometry tool for rapid arc. Choose the targets that you have planned, then that's going to show a different color in the BEV. And you can change the collimator angle and then see that how does it look in both beams. And even check the depth. And you need to create the control volumes actually to reduce the spills. In this case, now what you see is a control volume. And then I want to have one more control volume, so I'm going to contouring. Posterior neck, that's important. So I'm going to create a volume. I'm going to take a spinal cord as a initial thing. So I'm going to give the margin to the spinal cord anteriorly 0, and posteriorly it's about 3.5 centimeter. It's up to you. I mean, that's it. And I'm going to crop that that particular control volume from the other one what we had, cropping that. You have to do this because it's going to trouble you that if it is overlapping, then the constraints that what you give in optimization, that's going to trouble you actually. So it's better to crop that. Coming back to external beam. Once again, checking the prescription for optimization. What we use here is actually it's a PO, photon optimizer. We have lots to talk about this comparing to DVO. We will speak definitely. And now one has to give the minimum and maximum dose to the PTVs. Minimum should be your 100% dose, and the maximum should be 107% of the perception dose. And it is very important, the priorities. One cannot, one should not simply give 200, 150 or something like that. It should be 100. It is recommended. By giving a more priority, it is well proven that your MUs are going to be more. Lots of paper. And another thing, yeah, this normal tissue, I feel that, you know, these values are working very good with me, for me. And it's important that one should understand the target masking system in photon optimizer, because the optimization, because the resolution is same, unlike the DVO, in DVO you could actually change the resolution of each organ, but here it is same, 2.5, you could see there down. So it's very important to give a GTV also in constraint, because when it is a target masking, the PTV, the optimization algorithm is going to have lots of points on the surface of the PTV, but not the GTV. So one should definitely give a GTV. If there is a GTV node, or if there is a GTV primary, the constraint should be given to it as well. That is because the target masking system in PO doesn't look into the PTV. It just look into the surface of the PTV. So now the optimization is started. We'll talk a lot about this actually, intermediate dose verification. We need to talk about that as well. What is that? That's a GTV. Look at the main target. So by giving that constraint, what we actually do is that restricting the primary GTV dose going to the nodes. We'll show you the how the aquaplast has to be done, how it should be, and I basically don't model the base plate because I don't believe in that. Now, searching for the spinal cord. You should understand that the optimization is in hold. It doesn't mean that it is hold actually, it is still working. Hold it until you really understand what's happening. And the spinal cord has been, now it's okay. Now parotid. Just understand the vicinity of the parotid with respect to the nodes. Just keep the mean dose and then see how much it's already going, or how much it's already receiving it, and accordingly look at the distribution and then change the dose and the priorities. You don't need to rush it. You just see there first. So in this case is concerned, it's not necessarily that both products should get the same dose because the GTV nodes are on the left side. So you should try to respect that and then not try to really reduce so much on the properties, the other side. That's a GTV node actually. You can see the CTV as well, and it depends on the clinicians that how much underdose or overdose, whatever it is, how much the dose can be under dose to that PTV region, and then you can see even CTV whether it is okay or not. It depends on the clinician. They have their own practice. Just a matter of understanding how much it is overlapping and how much that we can achieve, how less that we can achieve to the parotids, and then the conformity. You have to just give the maximum dose, less than the prescription dose, probably 2 gray, less than to the maximum dose of the prescription dose. That's all. And then the posterior neck region, soft tissues, one can really reduce that, go for the 50% residual dose curve, and then the aim should be that 50% should not fall into that. It's not possible in all the slides, but majorly. It's not possible in all the slides, as I said, but majorly the 50% spill could be controlled. clearly see that in the sagittal. One has to be very careful actually, because by not allowing that 50% curve, acetose curve onto that, but you should not underdose as well the targets. So that is where the compromise things happen. Now it is in the third level. We'll definitely talk about what is these levels are and what's happening inside in later. And you should see that because of that control volume dose reduction, what is the minimum dose to the target actually. Minimum dose is very important, and where it is less, one should look into it and notify the clinicians. This is where the minimum dose is very less. Are you okay with that? And mandible dose is also very important. But as far as now, 66 is not going to the mandible, if I guess. I think it's only 59.4. Sometimes these cartilages are very important actually. It can even break if it is more than 70, 72 or something like that. That's what the clinicians they say. So, but it's important actually. It depends on the clinical situation, that whether it is the maximum dose, the global maximum dose should not be on the cartilage. It totally depends on the clinician. Now the intermediate doses calculation started. We'll definitely talk about that. What is this intermediate dose calculation? Why it is required? And then you have to hold it here to look at the true distribution. This is very important. Just hold it. This is where you have to see that maximum dose to the target actually. So it is going to be always more. So you are going to go for the compromisation now, the coverage, whether it is 98% or 97% or even down to 95%. It depends on your practice. But the hard spot, 1 cc should not be as per ICRU 107. So that's going to be a compromise on the priorities now. What you're seeing now is a true distribution. That's going to be the same, more or less. So this is where you should work. One should work on the hotspot. Looking for the lower percentage coverage. Trying to reduce the spill into the PTB 59.4. When you work on that region, that's going to reduce the main GTV dose into the PTB. in DVO it was really tough actually for physicist because we just work with the optimization and the experience, but we don't know really what's happening because of that. But in PO, it's real good that you do something, you see the changes right away in front of you. So it's a very good handy tool for physics. No, it's okay. After this intermediate dose is been calculated, one should see all the critical organs, how it is actually have come up. So just say okay. First of all, save it and then go for the calculation. Done. Acceptance is actually with respect to the clinical clinician of any institute. But it is a job of the physics to address that and give the plans according to their expectation. You can see that in air how much it is actually underdosing. But if somebody, if it is AAA, that's going to be no difference there. So that's what the accuracy is, and we'll talk about it. That helps the clinicians to see the true distribution. Though they may not, or we may not do anything about that, but still that is what is receiving there. So that is actually the TVH column, dose statistics. There is underdose. So because of this a controlled volume, there is underdose there in the PTV. So if the clinician is okay with that CTV, by looking at the CTV coverage and everything and your department setup protocol and everything, then that's fine. Thank you so much.